During the training of the Western Region leaders and labor inspectors on the NSSF compliance process, which took place at Lakeview Hotel in Mbarara City today, the Minister of Gender, Labor and Social Development, Betty Amongi, confirmed the appointment of Patrick Ayota as the new NSSF Managing Director for 5 years. According to the Gender Minister, Ayota's appointment followed the NSSF Board of Directors' recommendation to the Minister, which is in accordance with Section 39 and 40 of the NSSF Act.
Also was based on the report of the IGG, which has, number one, cleared all the board members, because Parliament's report is advisory, but the constitutional body that is mandated to undertake investigation is the Inspector General of Government and the Auditor General. So the report of the IGG did not implicate the board members. That is why I cannot take action on the board members. Equally,
the Gender Minister added that the appointment was timely, as they realized the uncertainty in the fund can cause a problem. She acknowledged the fact that the former NSSF boss, Biarugaba, had taken the IGG in court and the proceedings would take a long period of time, hence the need to stabilize the fund by appointing a new leader. The appointment was based on the IGG report, which declared all the board members and all the appointment procedures were done under law, and Amongi explains.
The former MD Richard Biarugaba has taken the matter to court to sue the IGG against the findings of the IGG. So at the moment, as an NSSF, we have to move forward because the fund is bigger than all of us. The most important thing is the stability of the fund, and that is the basis upon which all of us realize that the uncertainty can easily cause a problem. And so we decided that since the court matters take a long time, we need to stabilize the fund and move forward.
Patrick Ayota, the new NSSF Managing Director, promised a fundamental change and to do everything in his power to spearhead the growth of the fund.
You wake up every morning and do what's right to the best of your knowledge. It doesn't mean you're going to get 100%. But even when you don't get 100%, it's not because you didn't try. My thing is to try. Do the best. Take it one day at a time. And then leave God for the rest.
Over 300 government labor inspectors and the local government leaders from 35 districts attended the training. The training followed the partnership between NSSF and the Ministry of Gender, Labor and Social Development that was recently announced by the Minister Betty Amongi, aimed at leveraging the network of the labor inspectors across the country to improve social security compliance. Minister Amongi said that employer compliance with the NSSF Act has become a key area of emphasis, and rallied leaders at all levels to use their offices to mobilize and sensitize people to save with NSSF. She also asked the labor officers to be patriotic in serving people and warned them against entangling themselves in corruption tendencies.
I want to craft a partnership that will give you opportunity to also support government.
While addressing leaders during the training, the new NSSF Managing Director, Patrick Ayota, said that the partnership has been born out of a paradigm shift in thinking at the fund. He urged leaders to support the fund in its effort to increase the willingness to serve by ensuring all eligible businesses understand and comply with the NSSF Amendment Act, saying this is the first objective of the partnership with the Ministry of Gender, Labour and Social Development.
It does not matter whether in the formal or informal sector. It doesn't matter how much you make or you think you should make. Even if you make 10,000 shillings and save 1,000 shillings, over time it's worth it. So begin the habit of saving.
Leaders held NSSF for the training. However, they said such trainings need to be extended down to districts to cover a bigger number of the population.
When you have an information and you don't share the information, it becomes a dead information. So it is better if all these informations that we have got here, the whole region, isn't it? It is easier to go down to the districts and you call the district leaders and people who are concerned so that they can get information from the right hand.
The National Social Security Fund is a multi-trillion fund mandated by the government through the NSSF Act as amended to provide social security services to all eligible employees in Uganda. The company manages assets worth over 18 trillion shillings invested in fixed income, equities and real estate assets within the East African region. As the largest fund in East Africa by value, they have an ambitious goal of growing their assets under management of 20 trillion shillings by 2025. Story compiled by Abdul Karim Sengendo for the news.